there's something not good there that would want to be there, that we have to plant it and water it and cultivate it and all those things. So on the idea of love, I'm going to read 1 Corinthians 13, and then I promise you I'm through with the sermon part. Okay? 1 Corinthians 13, I'll be reading from the New International Version. This is what it says. It says, if I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I'm only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can find all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part, but when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see the full reflection as a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part. Then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. Now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Friend, will you take Heather to be your wife? We love, honor, and cherish you, keep her. And forsaking all others, cleave only to her as long as you both shall live. Heather, do you take a Bradley to be your husband? Will you love, honor, cherish, and keep him, and forsaking all others, cleave only to him as long as you both shall live? And will you join hands and face one another? And these are the vows. And Brandon, you'll repeat after me. I, Brandon, take you to be my wife. To have and hold. For richer, for poorer. For better, for worse. Sickness and in health. For death is not. I, Heather, take you, Brandon. To be my husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. For richer, for poorer, better, for worse, in sickness and in health, to death is part.
No. No.
The ring is a symbol and a reminder that the first. The ring is a symbol and a reminder of today. When Heather looks at this ring, she's going to remember not only that Brandon was here, but that her friends and family were here, and who was here, and how that she is loved. She's going to remember the commitment that she's made to you and Brandon. You receive this ring from Brandon's appropriate. Most important thing is that as they live with one another, and this relationship that we love would be bigger and better every single day. Till death do us part. So will you join us all in prayer? I'll voice the prayer. Our Father, we thank you for marriage. We've already done that, of course. But we pray that you bless this marriage. We ask God that your grace would be on this couple, that you provide for needs that we can't even think of today. We ask, Father, that you give them understanding and wisdom, but more than anything, we pray that you give them that love like you had for us when you died for us on Calvary. And now that Paul spoke about it in 1 Corinthians 13, help us to just grow.